Hello everyone, my name is Nilzo and this is Updated Stats, your weekly gaming news show focusing on role-playing games. Coming up in the news, Cyberpunk 2077 new informations, Obsidian-related reads, and some miscellaneous news. Some new elements about the CD Projekt Cyberpunk 2077 game has recently been put out. Game director Mateusz Kanik revealed that they are trying their best to stay true to both the cyber and the punk sides of this genre. Their world design will include typical tropes such as human-cyber enhancements, like in the Deus Ex games, but will also emphasize a lot about the grim future atmosphere in which individuals live in an unorganized world where massive corporations rule with little to no care about human ethics. The story of the game itself will not be about saving the world, but will be on a much rather low scale, focusing mainly on your character and his or her problems. The style and appearance that you will customize for your character will play an essential part, as also how you decide to express yourself in conversations, making the world around you react accordingly. Kanik indicates that to do so they are working on a totally new, unique dialogue system. It will therefore not be a game about police forces chasing after cyber-enhanced psychopaths, as seen in the trailer, even if this element will be included, but in a subplot rather than in the main focus. Release date is not determined, but 2015 seems a good guess. Chris Avellone, the creative director of Obsidian, that has worked on games such as Fallout 2, Planescape Torment, Icewind Dale, Star Wars Knight of the Old Republic 2, Never Return Nights 2 and Fallout New Vegas, has recently been interviewed by Game Industry International and Video Game Sophistry. He talked at length about story and character in games, the way they work at Obsidian, his prediction about where the gaming industry is heading, and its two current projects. If any of these interest you, you should definitely go check it out, links are in the description box below. Obsidian also put out a job offer for a level designer for one next generation game, indicating that plans for the Xbox 720 or the PlayStation 4 are in the work. Divinity Original Sin has been funded on Kickstarter. The co-op isometric RPG release date is due this November. Torment Tides of Numenera reached its last stretch goal. It means that elements such as player stronghold, expanded reactivity, length and depth, and even more emphasis concerning choice and consequence will be included. The Redkit toolset, a modding tool for The Witcher 2, has shown signs of progress with screenshots coming from the beta testers. That is all for this week, thank you for watching and see you later.